go to networking events in your local area and meet as many people as you can. May not necessarily be just to promote directly, but through that you can form relationships with people and meet as many people as you can to help drive to your business. Secondly, kind of in thinking of the local, in thinking of the actual local type of marketing, you can actually start your own meetup group of people that are interested in whatever niche you're in. So let's say you make sell women's fashion and you want to get together people that are interested in becoming fashion designers. Maybe you want to pick their brain on the latest ideas that can help spawn your next product. Start your own meetup. Meetup.com is a great way to create a local event and organize it.
That is going to the meetup groups. There's a website called meetup.com. No matter what you're selling, there's always people doing meetups in your city or in your town. Let's say you have something to do with the fitness. You have a fitness product. I'm pretty sure there's every single day is meetups happening in your city related to the fitness industry. Go out there, introduce yourself, and talk about fitness. In the end, everyone's going to ask you, hey, what you do? Because it's a meetup. You'd be like, okay, you know, I have a company with the great fitness product. And everyone's like, oh, what's that? And then you can be like, okay, this is my product. If you're interested, let me know. I have some special discounts, whatever. And it's one of the best way to promote your sales. I know you cannot scale it because you are only available in your town. But if you're living in a big city and you're going to 2 to 3 meetups every day where 30, 40 people come, you meet 3,000 people in a month. Let's say even 1%, if even 100 people buy that, you're getting like 100 sales just by going out and meeting new people. And they can give you great reviews as well because you have met in person, right? So it's one of the coolest things that have worked for some of our, you know, because I do organize meetups in 6 different cities, 5 in Canada, 1 in the USA. So I know there's like many people do this kind of stuff. But if you're living in a big city, it can be really, really helpful. If you're a people's person, if you like to talk a little bit, you can easily, you know, make them buy.
In another strange place, but you can't run a fixed ad. But what we do is we go in as a similar to an influencer-like relationship is meetup.com. And I've launched several brands, several e-commerce brands using meetup.com. One of them was a scuba brand. And I would find a scuba instructor. I'd create a meetup for like $85. And then I'd tell the scuba instructor, you're going to teach free scuba lessons. And I'd pay you on the side. So everyone's getting attracted for free scuba lessons and the instructor is actually teaching them and getting paid behind. But I would ask organizers of meetup groups to post a graphic similar to an ad in their meetup groups that are specific to the niche I want to launch.
Me being a seller and someone who has like extra space, like a warehouse, and someone who has the agency, every conference I go to, 10 different people try to partner with me for one reason or another. And it's like, okay, they want to be the official photo takers of all of our clients, or they want to be the 3PL that all of our clients use. And everyone knows that everyone else has a Rolodex and a contact list full of Amazon businesses. And they're always thinking of, okay, you know a bunch of people who like spending money on Amazon and make money on Amazon. I know a bunch of people who spend money and make money on Amazon. How can we pool together all of our contact lists together and all make money together because we technically don't compete with each other one-on-one? And that's what kind of just happens every time is that it seems like everyone, since they're in the same business, they see different ways where it's like, okay, I have a bunch of connections at China. You have a bunch of warehouses. How can we work this out together? And there's always some sort of connection like that there.
Form a relationship with no really pretense. These days, the whole conference and convention circuit is really exploding. There's tons of conferences. I know there's influencer conferences. There's conferences for affiliates. And what I would say is there's no better way to get to know somebody than to get a face-to-face meeting and really just form a relationship. The bottom line is one of the things that I always tell people with relationship building is what you always want to look at is not necessarily what somebody can do for you. That's really should just always be a benefit or an after effect of the relationship. But what you always want to do is just with no kind of pretense, not expecting anything from that person, just thinking about what it is that you can offer them, and leave it at that. So this could be done via going to these types of events, meeting them, finding out about who they are, forming genuine relationships with them, finding out about what do they need, you know, what are these influencers looking for, picking their brain a little bit, and seeing what you can do, what doors can you open for them, and then, you know, going from there, and then over time, they're going to learn to, you know, trust and respect you, and realize that you're not just in there just to try to poach them, you know, for their audiences. And I would just say, just, you know, really be yourself. But for number one, just always approach these relationships and the relationship building with what you can do for them first, as opposed to what they can do for you.
If you have one SKU and you sell a bath product, and they have one SKU and they sell a kitchen product, there probably isn't that much overlap. It's as your business has become more and more complicated, where you go, okay, I have 3 employees full-time in China who inspect warehouses, and they only work 20 hours a week. And I'm talking to another person who has 2 employees who do warehouse inspections. And I go, okay, you lay off your people, and we're just going to share my people. And then you have extra warehouse space in California. So when I just need to drop a container there for 2 days before I can bring it into Amazon, how about I drop it off at your warehouse? And they go, yep, that sounds like a deal. Good partnership. And so it's once business has become a little bit more complicated, you can find a lot more opportunities to work together. When you both have one SKU each and you both have your full-time job back home, there's not that many cool ways to work together besides just combining your bankroll together.